Welcome to Fox Den, the place to actually learn helpful therapeutic and psychology ideas. Here, we point out harmful myths about trauma, therapy, and counseling in general wherever we find them. That includes places like Reddit, Twitter, and any other recesses online where bad ideas multiply. Check out some of my interviews with YouTubers like Julia Christina, better known as Ready to Glare, and my interview with Blair, better known as the Illuminati. With Julia, I discussed trauma and how to find a good therapist. We discussed so many different ideas there about what to do when therapy fails, how to know when to look for a different therapist, how to know when someone can help you with trauma. And with Blair, better known as the Illuminati, I discussed a lot of cult psychology, multi-level marketing schemes, and how they get people hooked. And we also talked a lot about personality styles and what kind of personality traits leave you open to being exploited by cults and multi-level marketing. So check those out for some great information about how to protect yourself, how to use psychology to help you in a relevant way in your life. And so check out some of the videos that I've already got up. Be expecting a lot more. I'm going to put out content about attachment psychology, how to look for healthy attachment partners, how to know if your attachment is healthy, and how to rewire that to be secure attachment rather than anxious or avoidant. So for my intro here, I wanted to at least give a little something to chew on and talk about some common trauma myths that we deal with and that people tend to propagate and that we as therapists know aren't true. So the idea that exposure after the fact, after you've been traumatized to whatever traumatized you, is actually a good thing. So exposure is not always good. You don't want to go right back into whatever traumatized you, because unless you're in the right mental headspace or cognitive functioning, it could re-traumatize you, meaning it could make you even more sensitive to panic attacks and flashbacks the next time. So what you want to do is get a therapist who specializes in EMDR, eye movement desensitization reprocessing, or cognitive reprocessing, anything that really helps to titrate, meaning limit that exposure to a way that your brain can accept without freaking out and feeling like you're being traumatized all over again. So in other words, limiting that exposure, exposing yourself in a slower way and not re-traumatizing. So don't feel forced to right away go right back into what traumatized you, because that can sometimes do more harm than good. Another myth is that it means someone's crazy or that they're making stupid decisions. So if someone keeps going back to abusive partners or the same kind of person, they'll often feel like they're crazy. And that's just not true. What's going on is your limbic system, that the amygdala, part in your brain that's responsible for making impulse decisions, has taken over, and you're making decisions based on that part of your brain and feeling overwhelmed, and your frontal lobe is just not online. So, and again, there's awesome therapies that can help with that, like EMDR, that can help you in a careful way reprocess those memories and get your own agency and your frontal lobe back online, because there's a really logical answer for why people continue getting with harmful partners. And it all has to do with attachment psychology and what we feel comfortable with and what quells our anxious nervous system. So trauma doesn't mean you're crazy. It does mean that something's been done to you, and it's like an infection that can be cured with the right medicine, right? So that's cause for celebration, recognizing that trauma doesn't mean that you have some horrible disorder that's never going to go away. We know so many different kinds of therapies that work for it. And another really harmful myth that people can kind of throw out there on trauma survivors is that you have to forgive right away. You have to forgive your abusers or whoever is there. And sometimes that can lead to resentment if you're not ready. And sometimes it's better to say, I'm going to let this burden go. I'm going to let go what happened to me. I'm not going to let it happen again. I'm not going to make myself a mark, an easy target, whatever. But I'm going to stop obsessing about it right now, because that's interfering with my mental bandwidth and my mental RAM or cognitive abilities or capacity there. It's interfering with your own ability to live a full life. Forgiveness isn't something that needs to ever be forced. In the meantime, it's often better in the wake of trauma to really give yourself permission to be upset, to be pissed off, realize you didn't deserve it, and to find someone who can help you unload that burden. Again, preferably a therapist with some experience. So those are a few trauma myths that I hope I've exposed for you, and that you never come to believe. Now you know these things aren't accurate. So stay tuned to my channel for a lot more about this stuff. Like I said, my upcoming videos are really going to focus on attachment and how to avoid getting hooked into negative attachments that can replay some of your traumas. So stay tuned, check out some of my recent videos with awesome YouTubers, and there's plenty more to come.